carnavals font partie de la culture en Barbade. Rihanna avait grandi avec eux, mais peu de personnes le savaient car ce n'est pas une information qui avait été mise en avant dans la carrière de Rihanna. Sauf peut-être lors de cette représentation où Rihanna avait décidé de lever un instant le voile sur ses influences. Drapeau, danse, costume, tout avait été reproduit à l'identique pour se sentir l'espace d'un instant comme chez Rihanna. Nous étions au moment où la Barbade s'apprêtait à organiser l'un de ses plus gros carnavals, le Crop Over. L'occasion idéale pour nous de découvrir ce que Rihanna avait vécu dans son adolescence. The question is, are you ready for
Hello Belgium, welcome to Crop Over 2008 here in Barbados. Here we are on Spring Garden Highway at the Bridgetown Market. Come, let's show you around. Crop Over would have been one of Rihanna's favorite events. It would have influenced her widely in terms of her culture and her background. So, welcome to Crop Over 2008, Barbados' finest event. Hello, how are you? From Lambie TV in Belgium. We're from Lambie TV in Belgium, and we're here doing a documentary on Rihanna and Crop Over. So, Rihanna, because she's from Barbados, so we want to show everything Barbadian, and Rihanna just so happens to be one of the most internationally known products of Barbados.
Well, I'm glad to hear that. It's a coincidence because when her dad, I know her dad personally, when he was going up to his last story tour with her in between May and July, I sent up a package of my tamarind balls for Rihanna, and she likes them and Chris Brown loves them. So at least my tamarind balls have reached that far.
That's very good to hear. Hello, we're here in Spring Garden Highway on the Bridgetown Market, here under an umbrella. Of course, you know who sings that song, Rihanna, of course. Now we're here with two lovely Bajan people and we're going to ask them some questions on Rihanna. Now, how do you think Crop Over has influenced Rihanna's rise to stardom?
Well, it's a big influence, as in she's the international Bajan artist and she's, you know, professing Barbados as, you know, the, you know, rising star, and you know, but Crop Over is, it could be a big influence as well, you know, having the hot sun and having the umbrella keep the shade off you, you know, so it's a big influence.
Okay, and what do you think that Crop Over represents for Barbados in general?
Well, it basically represents our culture. You know, everything that we have to offer through the years, through history, we're just bringing it through Crop Over and just showing what Barbados really is.
So what are your big plans for Monday? Are you going to jump up? Are you going to have fun, drink?
Oh, yeah.
All right, well, thanks so much for your time, and we look forward to seeing you on Monday, all right? Okay, bye. What do you think that Crop Over in general has influenced Rihanna's rise to stardom?
Well, I believe the crop over is really shows out, it showcases how the Bajans really like to do things. It's cultural. It also helps with how we get, you know, how we do our things. When you go to the craft section, you see that we have our own style of making jewelry and clothing, preparing our foods and stuff, and it really gives us an essence of Bajanizing ourselves. As a Bajan would say, we put ourselves right there, we do things our way. Rihanna was born here, raised here, she did things the Bajan way, and now she's out there doing things publicly, and she's making a real statement for our Bajans.
Okay, thank you very much, and that was a very good interview, actually. How do you think Rihanna has been influenced by the Crop Over Festival in Barbados?
I think very much in such a way that in her new Disturbia video, she actually has on a feathered headpiece, which looks like one of our Crop Over costumes. So I think she's really trying to keep it into her music right now and into what she does.
So you know about Rihanna, right?
Yes, she's a good singer. Very good singer.
Right, you know she's from Barbados then?
Well, her mother lives not far from my friend, actually, in Barbados.
Oh, that's great. Can you tell me what flavors you have?
I got cherry, orange, coconut, ginger, and blueberry.
Wow, you have a wide variety of flavors down here. Do you think Rihanna would have loved the snow cones down here?
I would say yes.
Of course, as a proud Bajan, right?
Yes, she's a proud Bajan.
Okay.
Everybody loves you, so, you know.
Okay, thank you very much. Yeah. Here you go. Wow, it's really delicious. You know, now I see why Rihanna would have loved these things. They're really refreshing here in the hot sun.
15.
What do you think about Rihanna's rise to stardom?
Well, it's good. It's good that one of our people from Barbados got fame and everybody's recognizing Barbados now. They're just hearing her. We also have other artists like Rupee and stuff that made it and stuff, but I'm happy for her. Happy she's out there. She's representing Barbados and she's making all of us proud.
Think Barbados has influenced her development, especially the crop over season. How do you think that's influenced her development?
Well, it might be translated her music, the way she talks and stuff like that. Most of her songs, they have a little remnants of Barbados and her accents and stuff like that. So I think a lot of stuff that she brings out, it kind of reflects our culture and our music and stuff like that. Everything for crop over.
Dites, n'avez-vous rien remarqué durant ces interviews? Regardez derrière tous ces gens qui utilisent ces parapluies. C'est une habitude là-bas, on se protège du soleil. Les habitants en étaient persuadés, si Rihanna avait chanté Umbrella, c'était un peu en hommage à sa Barbade natale. D'ailleurs, vous ne le savez pas encore, mais les clips de Rihanna regorgent de clins d'œil pour ce pays. Que ce soit par ses costumes, ses paysages, ou des signes que seuls les Barbadiens eux-mêmes pouvaient comprendre. Ce trident sur le drapeau de leur pays par exemple. C'est un symbole fort en Barbade. Il signifie l'indépendance et l'avenir. Bien sûr, cela ne vous dit rien. Mais vous l'avez aperçu sans vous en rendre compte. Alors, verrez-vous encore les clips de Rihanna de la même manière ?